There is no doubt in my mind that becoming a web developer is an excellent career choice. The joy of seeing something that you create in the hands of someone else is quite incomparable. And it's never too late to start your web development journey. I personally started off as a telecom engineer and know of a number of highly successful developers that have come from alternate career paths. So in this lesson, we will look at how you can get started with your journey, we will look at the web developer roadmap and build a basic web application that should then help you polish your skills further. With that said, let's go. In my experience, there are four key steps in the web developer roadmap, and we will look at all of them in this lesson. First, we will develop a basic understanding of how the web works. Once you have this knowledge, you will set up a developer environment so that you can get started on your journey. In the beginning, we will create something simple. This will give you hands-on experience on the overall technologies that you will need to learn in order to become a web developer. Once you're comfortable, you can learn a bit more and then you can create something more complex and continue the process till you finally hit nirvana. So let's look at the minimum basics of how the web works. When you put in a URL in the browser makes a request to the server and the server responds with some content. The protocol that is used between the browser and the server is most commonly HTTP. You don't need to understand HTTP, just be aware that that is what is happening. And the content will exist of primarily HTML, JavaScript, and CSS, along with media like images and video. The browser will interpret this content and present it in a visual and audible fashion to the user. And depending upon the user's interaction with the browser might make additional requests to the server, and the server will respond with updated and new content. Now, this is quite a simplified overview, and we can watch it all unfold right in front of our eyes once we have the dev setup ready, so let's do that next. Now, a long time ago, it used to be quite complicated to get started with any form of development as you needed to install 100 different things. Fortunately, nowadays with web development, we can narrow it down to only 3 things. First up is Node.js. Not only does Node.js run all the server side, known as the backend of your web application, but it is also used to develop all of the code that runs in the browser, also known as the frontend of a web application. Next up is a code editor where you will be writing most of your code. Fortunately, there is a free and open source editor called VS Code available from Microsoft, which is what most of the web developers use nowadays. Now finally, in order to share your code with other people on the internet and to get code from other people on the internet, you will need a source control system. Git by far is the most common one used nowadays and is pretty much the de facto standard. All three of these softwares come with pretty easy to install installers for all the popular operating systems. So it is a simple matter of visiting the website, downloading the installer and running it on your system. I will leave links to the download pages for these softwares in the video description. Now with the setup done, let's jump into creating our first web project. Open up the terminal specific to your operating system and cd into a directory that you will be using for all your web applications. In my case, I call this folder repos, but you are free to call it whatever you want. Now when we install Node.js, we actually brought down 3 binaries. The first is Node, which is used to execute JavaScript applications. The second is npm, which is a JavaScript application that can be used to download packages that people have published on the internet, for example, the React package or Angular or Vue package. Finally, it comes with this binary called npx, which is a JavaScript application that can be used to execute other JavaScript applications directly from the npm package repository. For example, we can use this to execute the create React app application, which is something that can be used to create a new React application, which is what we will be using to bootstrap our first project. Execute the command npx create React app and give your first application a name. For example, we are calling it my first app. Now, while this command executes, let's talk about React a bit. By executing this command, we have made 2 choices. First, we are going to be using React as our front-end framework of choice. There are other popular frameworks as well, for example, Angular or Vue, but React by far has the greatest likelihood of landing you your first job. Secondly, within the React ecosystem, we are using Create React App to bootstrap our application. There are other ways to create fresh applications, and we could definitely do everything that this is going to do ourselves, but in terms of saving us time and setting us down the path of success, Create React App is an excellent choice as it is provided by the React team. Now, once the setup completes, we have our application ready for coding within the My First App folder. So the next step is to start coding in VS Code. Once you open up VS Code, you can select the Explorer side panel and then click Open Folder to open your newly created My First App. Now within Explorer, you can see all the files that exist within the current project, and your main application entry point is actually under source app.js. Before we start modifying this, let's execute this application. Open up the terminal within this folder and execute npm start. This will start this application in development mode, allowing you to play around with it. Once this application boots up, it will even open up your browser so that you can see this application in action. It's a very basic web application, but provides you with a good starting point to start messing around with HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Notice the text, edit source app.js, and save to reload. So let's jump back to VS Code. We already have this file open, and we will modify this text with some new one, such as Hello World. And now once we save this file, we can see that the text has updated within our web application. Now congratulations, you've made your first HTML change. What we are modifying here is actually JSX, which is just React's way of embedding HTML syntax within a JavaScript file. This file is actually a JavaScript file, as you can see by the .js file extension. After HTML, the next thing that we are going to modify is some CSS. We can see that this file is importing a CSS file called app.css, so let's open that up. We see this thing called app header that has a member called font size. The objective here is to not understand everything about CSS, but at least play around with it to see its impact within our web application. We can change the font size to some pixel value, for example, 100 pixels. As you can see from various names within this file, such as height and colors and font sizes, CSS is something that is used for styling your HTML. We've just bumped up the size of the app header, so if we go back to the web application, you can see that the font size of the Hello World text as well as Learn React has become much bigger. Congratulations, you've made your first CSS change. Now let's look at the final technology in the HTML, CSS, and JavaScript triad, which is JavaScript. So we jump back to our app.js file, and within the function app, we are going to create your first JavaScript variable called message, and we are going to store the string start coding fast. And now we can use this JavaScript variable within our HTML, that is JSX, by escaping. We use curly braces to escape from HTML into JavaScript land and then reference this message variable. Now, if we jump to the web application, you can see that the text has updated to show this message. Variables can be used in programming for various reasons, and one of them is reuse. For example, we can reuse the message on screen twice. And when we jump to the web application, you can see that it worked exactly as we expected. Now, the best way to think of HTML versus CSS versus JavaScript is that HTML are the elements that are shown on screen. For example, the text, the image, the button. CSS are what these elements are styled to look like. For example, we have a specific style for app header that we modified from CSS. And finally, JavaScript is the logic behind these elements. For example, what you want to happen if someone clicks any of these elements on screen, or other things that you can do with programming, for example, variables and reuse. Now, I appreciate the fact that as a complete beginner, a full web application such as that created by Create React App might seem a bit overwhelming, and that is completely normal. The objective here was to get you real-world coding as quickly as possible so that you can appreciate the fact that becoming a web developer is definitely something that is within your capabilities. The next steps would be to learn more HTML and CSS, followed by JavaScript, followed by React. If you enjoyed this lesson, smash that like and leave a comment. I normally cover more advanced concepts on this channel, so if you would like to see more of those, smash that subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.